In other news, options to save the retirement fund are fading fast. And according to fund actuary Buck Consultants, significant changes have happened in the last few years, but so far there's no sign of the change that's needed.
If I were the policymakers, I think at this point I'd go to the people and say, look, we've got a retirement system here. Not everybody in the world does have a retirement system, but we have, and it's broken. Nobody's going to just give us another one, so we really need to get together, arrive at one plan of action, and get busy fixing it.
That's Buck Consultants Principal Dylan Porter in a phone interview from California. According to the fund's recently released actuarial report, as of October 2010, the unfunded liability of the pension program stood at about $623 million, up from $592 million in 2009. The unfunded liability is the amount of money that would theoretically be required to pay out the retirement benefits of all of the members of the fund, roughly 6,000 people at the time of the report. Though he says this latest report is valuable and that it serves as a checkpoint for the state of the fund back in 2010, Porter cautions that it does not take into account several significant events that have occurred since then. The CNMI government's failure to fully remit employer contributions has been a major factor for the fund throughout its history, and especially in recent years. While the actuary has consistently recommended employer contributions of roughly $50 million every year, actual contributions have fallen far short of that amount, somewhere between $11 and $13 million. To date, the government owes the fund more than $300 million, an amount that continues to grow with interest and penalties.
This year, the report is important because it's a reminder to policymakers that this problem is still here. I think the projected date that the fund will run out of money to pay retirees is sometime in 2014, and essentially this report says that nothing has come along to change that.
The 2010 report also does not include the impacts of Public Law 1782, which allows non-retired members to withdraw their employee contributions with interest. Porter says the potential impacts are complicated to assess, but in any case, he wasn't asked to do so prior to the law's enactment. Asked if he's ever seen anything like 1782 in other pension programs or jurisdictions where he's worked, he says this.
Well, the Northern Mariana Islands Retirement Fund is by far my most colorful client. And so we've seen quite a bit together, you know, in the 6 years I've been serving the fund. There was a lawsuit and some public presentations and everything. But so short answer is no. I haven't seen anything like that.
He also expresses concern about a less discussed aspect of the law, which mandates that the Department of Finance determine how much the government should contribute to the fund, rather than having those amounts be determined through an actuarial analysis.
That's been de facto the situation for the last 5+ years, is the Department of Finance has just decided how much to put into the fund, and it hasn't really created a stable situation. So if Public Law 1782 is held up and found to legitimately replace Public Law 6-17, it doesn't give me a lot of comfort for the stability of the fund in the future.